She was going to get it. He called her and said, please bring me a morsel of bread in your hand. for myself and my son, that we may eat it and die. And Elijah said to her, do not fear, and go and do as I have said. But make me a small cake for me first, and bring it to me, and afterward make some for yourself and your son. But thus says the Lord God of Israel, the bin of flour shall not be used up, nor shall the jar of oil run dry, until the day of the Lord sends rain on the earth. So she went away and did according to the word of Elijah, and she and her son, and watch this, and her household, ate for many days. The bin of flour was not used up, nor did the jar of oil run dry, according to the word of the Lord, which he spoke by Elijah. If you don't mind, look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, give God what you have left. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, give God what you have left. I need you to look at a third person that don't want you left out and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, this is your personal sacrifice. Give God what you have left. If you agree with me, clap your hands in this room. That you read it, you can just open the door to church after you read it. This happens to be one of those. My brothers and sisters, one of the greatest challenges we face in this time and season is totally trusting God. In this season is totally trusting God. I'm saying one of the greatest challenges we have in this season of our lives is totally trusting God. We go to church, we read his word, we're in leadership. We attend faithfully, maybe some of the time. But when it comes to trusting God totally, we sometimes question ourselves as to whether we are doing the right thing or not. When the truth of the matter is, if we're not doing what God has said, we messed up already. See, our trust in God comes truthfully through our obedience to God. Somebody go catch that on the way home. Our trust in God comes through our obedience to God. I truly believe in God's word said we can stand on it, but our belief or our trust still sometimes comes with a sacrifice. I trust and I believe, Lord.
Provide.
When it came to him, his So you don't have to worry about what's going to happen to your sacrifice. God's going to do it just like he said he would. Clap your hands and give God some praise in here for what he's going to do in your life. So we find in this very familiar text, God leading Elijah to a place that was unfamiliar to him. He led Elijah to a place that was unfamiliar to him. The text says, and then the word of the Lord came to him, saying, arise and go to Zarephath, which belongs to Sidon, and dwell there. See, I have commanded a widow there to provide for you. I don't know who this is for, but God is preparing a place for you right now that you didn't see in your future. I don't know who I'm talking to, but God is preparing a job for you that you didn't see in your future. He's putting together something in your life that you didn't see in your future. God is going to do what he promised in his word he would do. All God is looking for is someone to be obedient to the assignment that God has for them.
That's not the boat.
Let me park here for a minute.
That's not the boat.
Nowhere in the text did Elijah ask any questions. He totally trusted God. Don't you deserve it? Nowhere in the text did Elijah say, why, God? He totally trusted God. Let me caution you here. If you're going to truly trust God, trust God. If you're truly going to trust God, I got happy myself. Trust God. If you're going to say that God is your Lord and your Savior, and trust God, then trust Him. See, what happens most times is we trust God to a certain point. And then we let go. We trust God to a certain point in our lives. Our breakthrough is there. Our deliverance is there. Our healing is there. And then we let go. You got to trust God in spite of and through it all. Can I get a witness in here? God wants our obedience and our faithfulness to be the ultimate sacrifice to the favor and blessing that he has for us. The text says, so he rose and went to Zarephath. And when he came to the gate of the city, indeed a widow was there gathering sticks. And he called to her and said, please bring me a little water in a cup that I may drink. And she was going to get it. He called her and he said, bring me a morsel of bread in your hand. Now I know she wanted to say, wait a minute. Not only do you want me to bring you some water, but you want me to give you some bread. Many of us don't want the last 20 minutes, 20 days, 20 hours to wait on is for what God has for you next. Look at somebody and tell them, your sacrifice is for what God has for you next. Look at what the text is next. So she said, as the Lord your God lives, I do not have bread, only a handful of flour to me, and a little oil in a jar. It's not going to gather these sticks, prepare something for my son, and we're going to eat it, we're going to die. And Elijah said, no, do not fear, go and do as you have said, but make a small cake for me first, and bring it to me, and afterward make some for yourself and your son. But thus says the Lord God of Israel, the bin of flour shall not until the day of the Lord sends rain unto the earth. I don't know who this is for, but you may have run out of some things, but you ain't ran out of everything. You may have run out of some things, but you haven't run out of everything. And many of us are crying over some things. Many of us are complaining about some things we lost. Many of us are mumbling and grumbling over some things we lost. I can understand if you lost everything, but you still got something, and you ought to praise God for the one something you do have. Give God praise for what you do still have. See, the power of God was not in what you had initially.
Trust in God. All you gotta
for God to step in. That wasn't me, that was the doctor. Your extremities are just the opportunity for God to step in. Yeah.